Item number three, authorization to the pre-treatment program for water and sewer.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, and Tim Perkins is here as well. I did bring a little bit more information for you. This is basically for them to set up a program to have industries that would discharge items into our wastewater system. So they'd have a permit if it was applicable. And what I'm passing out, our current provider, ESG, handles our contract for our, not only our water, but our wastewater treatment facilities. And they have done this before, have set up programs. And it basically is a questionnaire letter. They would look at our business licenses to see who would it be applicable to, go out and see more information. The beginning part, of course, is a little bit more time intensive than once it's in place. In talking with ESG, they are willing to work with us under our current agreement, our current contract with them, and basically just change the scope of services, and there would not be an additional cost at this time. Like I said, they've done this before, so they're willing to work with us on that and help the water and sewer department set up this program. They provide this preliminary information for us to review and for the water and sewer department to review. At that time, once it's set up and it's in place, then we could look at to see if additional staffing would be needed or not. We really think we can absorb it at this time. So I'm very happy. When we asked for this to be put on the agenda, we weren't sure if there was going to be a cost. We were really looking into it because of some issues that were happening within the county. So we're being proactive.
I would, was this brought forward because of the problem or it's time or something we've been thinking about or what? How did this evolve?
I'll let Tim ask. Yeah, I think it's a combination.
We've been expecting, when we reach a certain milestone, the state will require us to have this program. We're not there yet. When our flow hits, or our permitted flow hits 5 MGD, we'll be required to do it. It's federal rules. The EPA delegates to the EPD. EPD delegates it down to these authorities down to systems.
So
we don't have threshold? We don't have that yet, but we're getting close, and we have a ongoing problem that has brought this to light, and some issues between Fulton County and their authorities and our authorities that made us look at this. And so to get something in place quickly so we can, we really haven't had any industrial discharges going to any of our facilities, but we've got a current issue, and Fulton has concerns about their ability to come and enforce inside Forsyth County, and that's still being looked at.
I would like to ask, what are we, 5 MGD is the threshold?
Yes.
What are we at now?
I can't tell you our total permitted of all the plants. We're not there yet. They can require it at any time. They haven't yet.
Would it be inappropriate if you were to allow us to postpone this for a couple of weeks? I'd like to look into it a little bit more and talk to you a little more about it. I'm hesitant to add more red tape to our businesses right now.
You know, it's a problem that the sewer plants need, because you know, they have to monitor anything that goes in that sewer plant, and anything bad can mess our sewer plant up.
Actually, too. Well, without dealing with us, they're going to deal with Fulton.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not, they can't get around it.
I'm not suggesting, but we're going to put every business in the county under this type of program a little earlier than we need to solve one problem. Is there a way that we can solve that one problem without adding this at this point?
It wouldn't put everybody, it'd just be the new ones when they come in. They fill out a questionnaire and tell us what they're doing, which they have to do anyway.
I'm not against it. Don't think that I'm not supporting, you know, dumping hazard materials down the line. Right now, things are so tough in our businesses, you know, we're starting to see some rebound. And if it's not time to do it, do we need to do it? And if we've got one problem we're trying to catch, can't we address that one problem instead of implementing a whole new program?
Well,
they could have additional.
I don't know that we're approving this program. We're approving setting up the program. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
Which means if for some reason it comes back and there are, first of all, therefore, we have time to be looking into it as they set up what they believe the program will be.
How about a couple of weeks to talk to
them? It's not a real problem.
Investing time and effort into developing the program, that's all. I won't be able to report tonight. I'm not opposed to it, I just want time to dig into it.
Sure. I appreciate you being proactive also.
Oh, absolutely.
Well, we've been expecting to be required for a few years to do this.
You need to catch them on the front end before it causes a problem.
Yes, you do.
Absolutely.
That's the problem.
Exactly, and we, the one company we did deal with, they don't want to deal with Fulton, and they'd rather deal with us, so. So we can look at this and see what our options are.
I just like to dig into what that forward of cash that over everything.
Well, I would make a motion that we proceed with, or authorize you to proceed with the pre-treatment program. And what will you do once you, will you just implement this program, or you will bring it back for some sort of approval in its final form?
We'd bring it back during your comments.
My name is Chairman, I believe.
Are you guys okay with a 2-week delay? I mean, I don't want you to put work into it.
Yeah, I mean, that's fine.
With what we've learned today,
I don't want to put you under the gun.
I think 2 weeks is fine.
Okay.
Are you okay with that?
I withdraw my motion.
When we put this on the agenda, we didn't think we had 2 weeks.
I'll make a motion, we put it on the
May 3rd.
May 3rd work session. And then I'll schedule some time to come sit.
April 24th.
Okay.
Councilor, is this without?
April 24th.
If you want the next work.
The next work session, whatever it is.
April 24th. Do we need a vote on this, Councilor?
We don't. I mean, I've seen two commissioners consenting to it right there, so that's fine.
That's a special.
Yeah.
Who was the second on that? Todd, were you the second?
Second.
Okay. So we don't need a vote on that. Item number four, authorization to proceed with phase 3 and 4, the Fowler Reclamation Facility.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, members of the board. This is, as you're aware, we've implemented phases 1 and 2 at the Fowler Reclamation Facility, and the Water and Sewer Department is ready to move forward with phases 3 and 4, and especially since they're having a new pump station come on. At this time, we had encumbered funds when we opened the plant, when we had built the plant, knowing that this expansion would be happening, and that was in $2,002. We had a price variance agreement inside the contract that was based on the CPIU for that time period. So at this time, we're asking for the funding mechanism so we can move forward with phases 3 and 4. We have the $780,000 that's encumbered. With the CPIU from 2002 until present, it's a 19.23% increase. So really what we're asking for is a total of $929,963 to move forward with phases 3 and 4 at the facility. Thank you.
Dave, is this okay in the budget, or is this do weird thing?
We're okay. It costs money,
but
it's been dissipated within their CIP, and we're going to be looking at the entire CIP overall. It's just a small item in there, comparatively speaking. So it's in there.
Tim, do you have anything to add to this?
This has been anticipated, like Donna said. This money was set aside for this expansion, and it's just based on the CPI increases over time. This is something we anticipated having done this year for some potential savings with the Lower Big Creek pump station. And so because it was above the original encumbered amount, Dr. Best to come back and get the board's approval for the other. There's still some decisions, some things have to be made on what exactly will take place in 3 and 4, but this is by contract. This is something we're really obligated to do.
Principals of AECOM, Nick?
Yeah.
We had discussed, I think, at water and sewer meetings and such about some membrane options and things like that. Do you have anything you want to add to this?
Well, I don't know if it's really part of the agenda, but I can.
And that part of this expansion?
The expansion is, but this time we're just asking for the funding side of it, not the.
When are we addressing that today or not?
I had not planned on it, sir.
We're not addressing the supplier, but could we?
We don't have all of the
information
back. But can you address some of those things?
Talk about it.
Well, I can.
Well, first of all, what type of information is not back, and what form do you need it in to make you happy with your requirements?
We have asked for some information to justify changing the original contract. And We had several attempts at this, but we really haven't gotten everything. There's been some recent offers that maybe have been given to AECOM, and then I think recently, when we get the letter out last week.
If you don't mind, John and Nick.
Well, wait, I'd like to know what form you need that information.
We asked for a comparison, literally from what we currently have, what the type of membranes that we currently have in the facility. And we asked for specific items in our letter to be compared literally on the table.
They might be prepared to answer those tonight.
Yeah, but I think they want to know, right?
Well, maybe they have that, I don't know.
They have indicated they will be getting that information for you.
And since you don't have this information, my question to you is, I assume you need this. How can this therefore be time sensitive?
The time sensitive part is for the funding, to ensure that we have the funding set up for it. I have a feeling, the last time this was spoken about the membranes, it was spoke at the Water and Sewer Committee meeting.
Here's the part that I'm missing. If you got the money, but you don't have the information.
Well, to bury the contract.
Why don't we hear from the principal of the company? Why don't we let, instead, I mean, he's sitting right here, why don't we let him answer? He might have answers, he might have it in writing, we don't know what he has.
I didn't say he couldn't address the Board of Commissioners. I did want to know very clearly, very specifically, what it is that the head of our water department feels he needs and that he has not received so far in the form that he wants it in order for him to feel comfortable with it. Now, having said that, I would love to hear from anybody who is qualified to talk about this if the rest of the board is.
I'd love to hear what they have to say. This has been going on, we're running out of time to meet the...
Well, that's not our fault if we've asked for it in time.
We keep buying it.
Not if we don't have the information.
We just asked for it last week.
Okay.
So, let's hear from Nick and John. John, if you'll...
Chairman and Commissioners, just an overview, just to let everybody understand where we stand, and there's a reason why the decision on the expansion of the remaining two trains has not been made. The decision that needs to be made is based on the opportunity to replace all the membranes. We have two trains of membranes. They're 10 years old. They're reaching their effective life. There's a new generation of membranes. There's three vendors that have opportunities to provide that. We were going to have to replace those old membranes with other copies of those old membranes. So what we've done is we've offered to put that investment and our time and our labor into coming up with a system that would give you a brand new, complete new system. Restore the asset value of the whole plant and give you more efficiency, more capacity, that type of thing. So over the last 4 months, we've received a number of offers, a number of embellishments of offers, of opportunities to do that expansion. So the decision that we believe the county has to make is to decide on a selected vendor, and then that vendor would be the same vendor we would use for the phase three and four. So we think that decision has to be made first before that the final decision is on the expansion. So we've got three very competent vendors that have given us pricing. And to be honest, they're all very close together in terms of purchase price and our cost to implement. We really believe that this is the county's asset, and the decision to make that, decision on which vendor to use is really gonna be the county's, despite the fact that we have a long-term contract that goes on through 2023. We believe this is your asset. The decision that you make is going to be there for the perpetuity. So we've got three comparable systems. We have, we really don't feel that we should be making that decision. The differential is very close together. One of the vendors does have a few advantages in terms of additional elements that they provide. The Ovivo Kubota system can handle a much higher concentration of wastewater, and therefore you can get more capacity out of the existing system without expanding it. They've also offered to provide, as part of the lease payment over the next 3 years, a drum screen, which would improve the screening facility. So it's additional equipment that they're offering that has to be taken into account. That's not without cost itself, because just delivering that screen, we would have to rework that entire headworks in order to accommodate it. So, although we've got three comparable membrane options, there is one that is offering quite a bit more in their offer.
What is the value of the screen if we were to buy it?
The screen itself is over $300,000, and that's on top of the, I mean, that's included in the cost they've offered for the
Except we have to do somebody has to do some.
Right. I mean,
retrofitting, I guess?
Yeah, essentially what we have is a system that takes the water through channels and distributes it at the current hydraulic gradient and goes through the plant through gravity. This would have to be piped up, and the flow would be lifted up to the higher level to go through the screen and then come back down into the channel.
So, look, it is, if I hear you right, it is our decision. You're comfortable that it is our decision. Are you comfortable potentially making a recommendation to us about what our decision ought to be?
Well,
they're all the same.
This is where I don't want to get in the middle of decisions. There's a lot of opinions, even within the commission and within the department. The department has a stake in this. They're ultimately going to run this. So for us to make a decision, I think is, we can always do it, but I think it's unfair to
the county. What's the lifespan of these membranes, though?
Well, the membranes can last 7 to 10 years, but once you decide to go with one or the other process, you're committed for the rest of the project. I mean, it'll take you another $1 million to convert back to another system. The decision you make will define this plan for the next 20, 30 years.
And apparently, I don't know whether there's a discrepancy or what, but there's some kind of a thing at the moment between the information perhaps that you have or can get and the information that Tim needs and or the time frame.
Well, we're talking about...
Is this a resolvable problem?
Well, I think what we're going to do, I mean, first of all, none of the vendors has agreed to our terms and conditions. I mean, we have to have a contract with them. We don't really want to sign up all three firms and then select one after the fact. So whichever option you choose, we'd like to go ahead and move ahead with them and make it, develop a contract. We have to do construction work as well.
Your items that you're looking for, answered, there's a list of 8 or 10. Is it comparisons between products, or just you need some assurances that there's certain thresholds met, or what?
A little bit of both. It's the existing contract is written around the Xenon, and so in the dollars that you talked about approving earlier were for a specific product. So we need something to show you that what you're getting meets or exceeds that product, or you'd be able to ask back some money. If you're going to let them go with something half as expensive and half the value, you'd expect to get money back. So we need to give you something that shows the board that by the existing contract you're getting a betterment.
But we know that Xenon, when they were originally asked for a quotation, once they found out there were some other people in the game, they cut their quote by half.
Well, let me interject one thing. There is money set aside for membranes, but that was, you got to remember that, our cost is adjusted, our operations cost every year is adjusted by the CPIU, which is really a cost of living adjustment. It doesn't take into account the changes in import tariffs, the changes in the cost of steel. That's an equipment item. We're being held to the cost of living increase for something that has changed probably almost 30% in cost, but we have a 20% increase.
We've been through this in two or three water and sewer committee meetings, and I can't tell you how many other conversations. Based on what I've heard, it seems like if he can assure you that the specifications are met that you're looking for, that the Kubota product would be a better product, especially now that they're going to give us a three-year, $400,000 screen. Why don't we go ahead and allow this to move forward as long as they can satisfactorily answer those questions? Meaning, if we were
now, have they made a presentation yet? The $400,000. I mean, he
made it at Water and Sewer Committee.
Yes.
I mean, we have. There's been a lot of discussion on the Water and Sewer Committee. Mm-hmm. I'm comfortable with making a motion to award or ask them to use the Kubota and get the new screens and all that, provided they satisfactorily answer these questions, because we're 4 months behind schedule.
Will this Kubota system add life to the system?
It'll add life to the system, it'll add capacity to the system.
That's what I want, the capacity. What do you think will add capacity, and how realistic is it?
Well, one thing about
Do we have anybody we can ask that's done something similar in an exchange or change up that can verify that?
Well, let me suggest, we're getting a brand new system, first of all. So, you know, your asset has now got a new 10-year life, okay? The Kubota system is a flat plate membrane. It's different than what we've been using, which is hollow fiber. It does allow us to increase the capacity of the existing plant. We can concentrate the waste much greater. I'm not committed to the full value, they think, but it's certainly higher than we can out of a hollow fiber. It's at least 25-30% more. It could be more than that. So we know it has.
Yeah. I mean, this actually good news, because that has a value to your plant.
Right. Right. Well, that's value to our plant. Right. And the more capacity we can run through it, it helps you, because the capacity, and this is something that I feel we have to address at some point, is not hitting the numbers that we had anticipated when we started this project, because of this the downturn in the economy. It's not something that's controlled by anybody. I think at some point we're going to have to address that too.
Well, and let me offer that, you know, we're the lowest cost game in town. You're currently paying for every 1,000 gallons we send to Fulton County $4.03. Our operating costs are about 87 cents per 1,000. So every gallon that you can move towards the Fowler plant, assuming we can permit to dispose, it dramatically helps you. It's almost dollar per gallon. So if you could move quarter MGD to the plant, you gain 300,000 per year. So each year you save that.
Pay for its own new product.
Correct. We're getting close to that.
I hear the value. I totally understand the value of doing the change up. Just wanted to know if there's any history of this product and how well it performs. That's all. They have been around a while.
Okay. The only thing missing from this discussion, that change out's not free. And so we haven't discussed the extra cost that you'd have to also approve, and that's what we don't have yet. We had a proposal earlier. Things have changed in the last few weeks. Some additional offers have come in, and so we haven't gotten back what I can tell you today, what this additional change out of what's in the detail of the extra screen, if there's extra cost. So that's what's still missing, is the numbers to lay in front of you.
I would love that kind of have everything. But can't you wait 2 weeks for 30 days to get everything?
What do we need to do? We're 4 months behind schedule.
I'll be honest. I need a decision from the county to make to go to one vendor or another. I can't be going to all three vendors and getting pricing.
Can you wait 2 weeks or 4 weeks to do this? Or are you at the deadline?
If you can give me a direction. I mean, anytime. What's holding?
It'll give them the time to get the information they want.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
What do we need to know the cost differential to use the Kubota versus the right?
Well, I'm used to an environment where you do get quotes of some kind from all vendors. So can you just address why you can't ask all three vendors for something?
Well, we would have to give them all our terms and conditions, and they have to reprice everything they've given us. And they've been giving us pricing since December, and they give us new pricing in the last 2 months. We could certainly do that. It's going to take a little bit of time, but we can do it. Right now, our biggest issue is having to negotiate with three firms. I mean, we don't really want to get to that level. Each one's uniquely different. The construction contract we have to do construction on each one. So I'm going to have to get quotes from a contractor for each one.
Okay, and so I have the relationships right. You guys have been satisfactorily and successfully servicing the county for some time now, is that right?
Correct.
And so what I think I heard from you is, from your point of view, based on your expertise, you would like to proceed without contacting or without going with all three of these guys. I think you've been pretty clear, or you've been in contact enough. Maybe that's the way to say it.
I think so. I guess my point is, at some point I need to give them a negotiation package.
You got to do a formal.
Yeah, I want to say that we've been directed by the county to proceed with you this firm. If we don't come to terms, then it's another.
And that's actually your recommendation about how to proceed. As an expert to the county, that's what you're saying.
That's okay.
And I respect that and would like to try to do that. My personal position is would be to support you on that approach as long as these two folks down here are happy with whatever it is they need to be made happy about.
And I need to find out. You need those 10 questions or 12 or whatever it is. You need that provided.
We've asked for it previously. Right. And this time we just enumerated them very clearly.
So we need to also then understand what any additional cost would be to utilize wet membrane as well as the retrofit cost for this new screen.
If you do that. And also if you are interested in changing out phases 1 and 2. Is what I'm hearing.
Well, I think what I'm hearing is the topic of phase 1 and 2 is on the table, and I guess from staff standpoint, the question that we would have is, does the change out of 1 and 2 along with adding 3 and 4, does that justify the capital modification clause in the contract? If in fact it does, then we may need to let the commissioners know about that clause. So in your opinion, does that
Well, we've offered that we would finance the cost of these membranes over a 3-year period, and that cost would be essentially paid through monthly payments, just increasing our monthly cost. So we would take the responsibility for the contract. The county doesn't have to purchase the equipment. And it'd be one sole source opportunity. So we absorb the financing cost, but we distribute your share, the county's share, over a 3-year period.
Well, this is what the bonus is, right?
Well, this is whichever one. Yes,
yeah, right. We got to pick one. You want to pick one system, go
right. And I'm going to give. I would give you a cost.
Well, we don't know. We keep talking about.
Well, because there are different.
We had 3 water and 2. We talk about these same things.
And what I understand, the closed system gives you extra capacity, which could help come up with the funding to pay you for that 3 years, anyways. From understand, because we'll be able to treat more at our plants instead of sending to full account.
Choose Kubota, we can get all numbers from them.
It's about 12,000 a month, then they have to go to the voter system.
It's a little bit more than that because there's a lot of transition costs.
Tell me what it is.
Well, and that's the way, that's what we need to have. It's a little bit more than that. I can't tell you exactly.
That's why you shouldn't, maybe you shouldn't give them time to
do that. No, I thought we had, it's 10%.
Actually,
As I said, until I get them to agree to my terms and conditions, I don't know what those costs
today
are.
Really the first day we've heard AECOM admit that they might be agreeable to the extra capacity from the Kubota. The last time we met, they were uncertain if you'd accept that. So things are evolving.
But how do we, if we don't know what it is until they get into final negotiations, why don't we give them the authority to get into those final negotiations with Kubota and bring it back to us? I mean, if we're not gonna know, we're not gonna know. And at that time, they can also answer these questions. But what we're doing is we continue to delay, and we're 4 months behind schedule already.
Well, we'll just make a motion to look at both, pick out a single source to go with.
They go in a second.
Well,
and bring it back for
why do we care that we're 4 months behind schedule?
We just asked for them to recommend. We think it's important that they make a recommendation.
Well, that's a shifting. I mean, I understand that. I think what we're trying to
First of all, we've already offered that. We'll take full responsibility once that decision is made. We can use any of these buildings. We're not.
Okay,
we will stand behind our project.
What I think.
And that you don't have to worry about.
Commissioner Amos said is, why don't we ask that or instruct to move forward with the project with Kubota to answer these questions,
get
the final calls to
get the numbers,
get into the details with them, because until we tell you to go with, we can't get the final numbers anyway.
That's
so we just continue to spin the wheels.
And I was still getting changes even last Friday. So
I would make a motion that we give the authorization to proceed with phases 3 and 4 with AECOM and Fowler Wastewater. I'm not going to give an amount yet, but that they bring back a final cost to us and details. I'll say details defined as y'all's, the questions that you need answered to feel comfortable. If you're not comfortable, then we will not move forward. But right now, let's get them moving forward.
Well, let me just one more thing. It's very difficult for us to have two different systems.
No,
we have to have one system.
No,
you said three and four.
I'm sorry,
phase 1, 2, 3, 4.
And replace phases 1 and 2 with
About Kubota.
So don't they need a dollar amount? Isn't that what you asked for, Tom?
Well, we were just going forward with phases 3 and 4. We're not pursuing phases 1 and 2 at this time.
They want to play all.
This is a different proposal that's on the table.
We want to play all the same. To increase that capacity. So that phases 1 and 2 as well.
Yes.
Second.
And bring it back, when can you bring it back? 2 weeks?
I think so. 2 weeks. I think we can do 2 weeks. We'll plan it. We'll get on right away.
Is that acceptable? Why don't you plan on, if I can, I hate to keep going, why don't you try to get it back to them in a week so that they have a week and then we bring it back to our meeting in 2 weeks?
I think they were struggling with 2 weeks.
That's all right.
We'll do that.
A week to 10 days.
They're not careful, we can do it.
I want to declare procedurally, I think there was a motion. Okay, I heard a second. I want to make sure that you were clear on. I didn't make a motion.
Okay, all right, that was a.
I agree with you.
No, mine wasn't a motion.
So the motion is to proceed with 1, 2, 3, and 4 with Kubota and then bring back the full details and full specifications to purchasing and the director of water and sewer to then be presented in the next regular work session on board commissioners.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously. Next item.
Sam, you got to still go on consent. You got still go on consent.
The next item, Mr. Chair, members.
I believe next item is number 5.
Pardon me?
Of an RFP.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, members of the board. This is for the RFP 1220-3150. And this was for the design work for the intersection.
That brings us to the end of our agenda. Council, do we have a need of an executive session?
We do, sir.
You do?
Yes, sir.
Do I hear a motion to adjourn this meeting and enter executive session?
So moved.
For the purpose of litigation, personnel, and land acquisition.
At 4:30.
And we'll start at 4:30. That part of the motion?
Yeah.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
That passes 4-0. We are adjourned at 4:21. Any other changes to the agenda?
Mr. Chairman, Council members, appropriate, we do have staff here. I think Don is here to address that item. Can we move that to the beginning so she can do it?
We can, and that will take a motion and vote to put it in front of the order of the new business agenda.
Is that what you would like to do, have a public hearing? I'd like to put it ahead of public hearings, so she can go ahead and do it, unless she wants to. Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we move new business number two, which is the discussion on phases 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2, 3, and 4, Fowler Reclamation Facility. And just put that in front of public hearings.
Second. And we need to vote. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And if you favor, signify by saying aye. Please vote. By pressing your button. Thank you. That passes unanimously.
And Mr. Chairman, I know this is going to be absolutely confusing. I should have thought about it earlier. I'd like to make a motion that we postpone new business item number two to the May 8th work session. That's what it should have said in front of public hearings.
This is the cup?
No, sir, that's the...
Well, we just moved it from...
Yeah, we just moved it on. And instead of putting it in front of public hearings, I should have postponed it to the work session.
So you want to postpone it now to May 3rd?
Or May 8th work session.
May 8th.
We have one before. We have a work session on Tuesday. Up to you.
Would that be our September 24th PLC? This is 24th fifth schedule.
I'm not sure we'll have the information. There's been a request for a 2-week extension from...
Let me put it on the 24th, and if we need to postpone it to the 8th at that time, we will.
Commissioner Bell, may I expect a request that is moved from consent agenda to the front of public hearing agenda? Can we just get to that?
You want to write...
Approve the agenda, and then let's get there, and then let's postpone.
Thank you. I was just trying to get Donna out of here. Sorry, Donna.
Are there any more changes to the agenda? If not, do I hear a motion to adopt the agenda as changed and modified?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and second. There's no discussion. We vote on the motion, and that passes unanimously. Public hearing. No. Oh, yes. Motion to...
So, new business number two, which is the previous consent agenda three, consent agenda B, and B. Make a motion to postpone this item until the April 24th session.
So,
we have a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. That passes unanimously. Now public hearings.